Welcome to the tutorial on use of LaTeX for report writing and presentation. In this session, we will cover brief history of LaTeX and then we will see how to install LaTeX and its associated softwares in Windows operating system. Let's get started. LaTeX is actually pronounced as LaTeX or LaTeX. Note that this X is pronounced as K. Hence, it is to be pronounced as LaTeX. LaTeX is a document preparation system for high quality typesetting. What do we mean by this typesetting? Typesetting means it is the arrangement of contents in the page so that it is appealing for the viewer. So here in typesetting, all the care is taken in such a way that the contents are properly arranged in a page so that when the viewer starts viewing the document or reading the document, it should appeal the user or the viewer. So these days we have digital typesetting. Hence LaTeX is a digital typesetting tool which arranges the content in the document to make it appealing for the viewer or the user. Where is LaTeX used? LaTeX is used for medium to large technical or scientific documents. So if you are in a process of writing a scientific or a technical paper, then it is always good idea to learn the use of LaTeX. But having said this, we are not restricting ourselves to only medium to large documents. It can also be used for almost any form of publishing. Even large volumes of books can also be typeset using the LaTeX tool. In fact, most of the publishers use the LaTeX tool for publishing documents or books. It is to be noted that it is not a word processor. What is the meaning of word processor? It's an application wherein you will simply type and you decide what will be the arrangement of the fonts or arrangement of the content in a page. Best examples of word processors are Microsoft Word and other such softwares. So LaTeX is not a word processor. Then what it is? It is what you see is not what you get. What you see is not what you get. It means what you type in the LaTeX editor is not the output that you get. So this is famously referred to as WYSINWYG. LaTeX encourages authors not to worry too much about the appearance. When we are using Word, we tend to give too much focus or attention about the appearance of the document and forget to load the content. In fact, in a document, content is important. Of course, appearance is important, but by the use of word processors like Word, we also spend a lot of time in formatting the content according to a proper appearance. But LaTeX makes us not to worry too much about the content, about the appearance, and worry only about filling the content. Before moving into the brief history of LaTeX, we will see what is TeX Tech is a typesetting program created by Donald Knuth. K is silent here. Who is this person? In fact, Donald Knuth is an American computer scientist and also mathematician and a professor emeritus at Stanford University. He has received ACM Turing Award during 1974. For the audience, those of you who don't know what is Turing Award, it is informally treated as Nobel Prize in computer science. So this person originally created Tech program, a typesetting program, for his great work called Magnum Opus, The Art of Computer Programming. During the creation of this work, he was not happy with the typesetting that his publishers were able to achieve. So to solve that problem, he decided to create his own typesetting program and then called it as a Tech typesetting program. This is how the journey of LaTeX began. Now, what is Tech? Tech, it takes a plain text file. So it is to be noted here that the input to this Tech, rather LaTeX, is also a plain text file and converts it into a high quality document which is compatible for printing or for on-screen viewing. Why LaTeX is still famous, even though its creation is very old, is because it is suitable for on-screen viewing or it is suitable for digital viewing. Then came the LaTeX. LaTeX is a macro system built on top of Tech that aimed to simplify the use of LaTeX and automate many common formatting tasks. So the Tech typesetting program was a bit cumbersome and difficult to learn and use. Hence, to overcome such difficulties in learning curve as well as make it easy to use, LaTeX was developed. A macro system on top of Tech was developed and it was named as LaTeX. Now, why only it was named as LaTeX? Again, there is a reason. Let us see what is that. LaTeX is now the de facto standard for academic journals and books. So if you are interested in publishing a paper in a famous journal or a conference, then you might be mandated to use LaTeX format only. And it is the best typography software. And one more advantage of LaTeX is it is free to use. What is Tech? Tech is a typesetting language used to typeset documents attractively as well as consistently. It was used to explore potential of digital printing equipment. A programming language in the sense that is Turing complete. In other words, Tech is a program that is Turing complete. Now, what do you mean by a Turing complete? In computability theory, a system of data manipulation rules are said to be Turing complete if it can be used to simulate any Turing machine. Now, the next question comes, what is a Turing machine? Viewers from computer science background will be easily able to tell this. A Turing machine is a mathematical model that defines an abstract machine that manipulates symbols on a strip of tape according to a set of rules. And these days, virtually all programming languages are Turing complete. It is to be noted that during 1970s, Tech was a Turing complete program. Most of the time, Turing complete programs or programming languages are virtually bug free. But Tech's job is that of markup language for describing how your document should look. What is a markup language? In computer text processing, a markup language is a system for annotating a document in a way that it is syntactically distinguishable from text, which means when the document is accessed by the screen, markup language is not shown and is only used for formatting the text. You might be asking, give me one example of markup language. HTML is one of the best example of markup language. Those of you who had learned HTML, they know that what you type as an HTML code is not what you get. In fact, you write in HTML something called as tags, and tags represent how the text should appear in the document. Markup language terminology is used for such type of programs. Tech is renowned for being extremely stable. Why it is stable? Because it is Turing complete and running on many different kinds of computers, being virtually error free. Again, it is because of the fact that it is a Turing complete program. Now we will focus our attention to LaTeX. Till now we saw Tech, and now we will study what is LaTeX. In fact, we had already seen one point in the previous slide which talked about LaTeX. It's a macro system built on top of Tech. Now let us see that point in detail. LaTeX was first created by Leslie Lamport. In fact, the two words or two alphabets LA which precede Tech has been taken from Lamport, LA. Who is this person? Leslie Lamport is an American computer scientist best known for his work in distributed systems. The viewers from computer science background who have already studied distributed systems, they know or they would have studied many of the algorithms proposed by this person, Leslie Lamport. So LaTeX is also a contribution by this great person, Leslie Lamport. As stated earlier, it's a set of macros for Tech language. What it does, or what is the advantage of LaTeX? It simplifies the Tech typesetting, especially for documents containing mathematical formulae. We know how difficult it is to write or represent equations or mathematical equations in Word. It is time consuming, cumbersome, and also lot of tiring on the part of the user. But however, if we learn LaTeX, typesetting mathematical formulae becomes very trivial. We will be seeing how to typeset mathematical formulae in the further sessions. And one more advantage of LaTeX is it comes with a lot of packages or styles. There is a website called ctan.org wherein you can get full LaTeX packages. CTAN stands for Comprehensive Tech Archive Network. Let us have a look into this website. You can see here, this is the website. So if you are interested in getting new packages, you can easily refer this site. So all the packages with respect to tech are available in this website. You can easily download all the tech packages. Let's get back to our discussion. Moving on to the next slide. The question is, why should I use LaTeX? Few part of this question is already been answered in the previous slides. As noted, we can concentrate only on the structure and the contents of the document, and LaTeX takes care of its typesetting. We need not spend so much time on the appearance of the document. We can concentrate only on its structure as well as the contents of the document. And another advantage is document structure is visible to the user and can easily be copied to another document. This is because as the LaTeX code or LaTeX file is a normal text file, any editor can open the text file and you can easily copy the content from one document to another document. This is not possible easily in case of word processors, because word processors have specific headers. If you have not installed word processor like MS Word, you will not be able to open such documents because they are simply not text files. Another greatest advantage of using LaTeX is indexes, footnotes, citations and references are generated easily and automatically. You might be wondering in the books, how would they write indexes as well as references in each of the chapters? They would have used similar such tools. The publishers would have used similar such tools to generate that. No single person has typed those indexes, bibliographies as well as references. It has been generated automatically by programs very similar to LaTeX. They are referred to as typesetting tools. Mathematical formulae can also be easily typeset. And biggest advantage of using LaTeX is it is free of cost. You can easily download and install without any hassle. All these points should make me or should motivate me to use LaTeX. As stated earlier, LaTeX document is a plain text. Document sources can be read and understood with any text editor. Tables, figures, equations can be generated programmatically with any language. Changes can be easily tracked with version control software. LaTeX can produce documents in several formats. And one of the famous format that we all use for reading online books or journals is PDF. So your LaTeX code can easily be typeset to PDF document. So basically, LaTeX supports DVI. What is DVI? Device independent format, as well as PDF. By using other necessary softwares, we can easily create PS or PostScript, PNG or JPEG, so on and so forth. Other formats also. Now let us see how to install LaTeX. Tech and LaTeX are available for most computer platforms. They are most commonly installed using a distribution such as TechLive, MicTech, and MacTech. TechLive is meant for Linux-based operating systems, or this distribution is for Linux-based operating system. MicTech is for Windows. MacTech, as the name itself suggests, it is for Apple operating systems or Macintosh operating systems. And TechLive provides comprehensive tech system with binaries for most flavors of Unix, including GNU Linux and also Windows. MikTeX is an up-to-date implementation of Tech or LaTeX and related programs. As stated earlier, MacTeX is a Mac component of Tech. These are a few of the few screenshots of those three distributions: TechLive, MikTeX. So to be able to download, we should go to download section and then download the recent version. MacTeX. We'll continue with the discussion. I can list out few issues with the installation of LaTeX with those distributions. Issues, I mean, installation and configuration is a bit cumbersome and bit difficult. Of course, with the recent distributions, this problem might not arise for even a common user. And these distributions don't come with built-in text editors. So we must rely on the base operating system editors. So we can install TechWork, TechStudio, so on and so forth. So the solution is, you can use online LaTeX editors, wherein all these things are not needed. No installation, no need to rely on the base operating system editors. Just use the online editor, which comes with the pre-built installation. There are many online LaTeX cloud-based editors. Two of them I have listed here. They do provide all-in-one features. They also support online collaboration. The biggest advantage of using online cloud-based LaTeX editors is you can collaborate. Imagine a situation wherein you are using LaTeX for typesetting your project report, and in your team there are four members. So if you are using a LaTeX distribution and installing it in a standalone machine, then all four have to work in a single installed machine. But if you are using online cloud-based editors, all four can contribute individual chapters to your project. But having said that, sometimes the online cloud-based editors might require some paid subscriptions to enable all the features. Usually, online collaboration feature will not be of free in nature. It will be usually paid subscription. Few of the famous online LaTeX editors available are Overleaf as well as Authoria. I have now downloaded these two files called Basic MikTeX and TechStudio. The link to download these executable files will be provided in the description below. MikTeX is a program, executable program, that contains all the basic core libraries for LaTeX distribution. TechStudio is an IDE which makes us type the LaTeX code easily. First, I will install MikTeX. I will run as an administrator. Click on yes. It will open this window. Click on accept MikTeX copying conditions. I will choose install MikTeX for anyone who uses this computer. It will, since I have installed 64-bit version of this MikTeX, it is showing me this path. Click on next. One peculiar behavior of MikTeX is, since MikTeX distribution contains only the base features or the base packages, if your LaTeX code is using some additional packages which are not part of the standard distribution, it will take those packages on the fly by getting connected to the internet and then download it and then compile your program. So it is asking me here what should happen to the new packages. So there are various options which you can select. Out of this, I will select yes. It means it will not ask me every time whenever a package is missing. It will install it on the fly. I'll click on next. I will tell you why I have not selected ask me first, because if your code contains so many missing packages, for every package when it is being installed, it will always ask you a dialog box, which becomes annoying at some times. So I will select not to ask anything, directly download the missing packages and install. I'll click on next, click on start. It will take some time to get it installed. As you can see here, it provides around 214 packages. Let it get installed. At the end, it will give you a message. It might give you a message based on how updated your distribution is. Here it is asking me or showing me never checked for system-wide updates. You can just click on next. It will ask you to specify the updates. So updates, depending on the version that you have downloaded, if it is older, here I have not downloaded the recent version of Miktex from the website. This is a bit older, hence it is asking me to check for updates. I will keep this box checked, click on next, close. This is the installation of Miktex. It will open the browser and ask you to and open the thank you page. You can just close this. Next, we will try to install TextStudio. Again, I will select run as administrator. It's again a basic installation. Simply click on install. It's 32-bit software. Just click on install. The installation wizard is of old GUI nature. It got installed. Close. If I go to the desktop, you will see if I go to the start menu, you will see TextStudio. You can also see the Miktex console. I will now, having installed both softwares, I will now click on TextStudio. Sometimes, depending on the version, it will ask us to update. Click on OK. In the next video session, we will understand the basics syntax of LaTeX, and then we will write simple LaTeX code to typeset few of the interesting documents. We'll be using TextStudio for that. Thank you.